Well, evolution is a very good designer of systems over time, so a lot of the things that would be very difficult to think up on your own, it's easy to just copy from what nature has already done.
I don't think I've ever given that much thought to animal behavior relating to robotics and everything, but because of this class, it's definitely a new field of study that I'm interested in learning more about.
We really do build our technology based on human life and what makes things easier for us.
You have this obvious connection, but you don't know how it connects, and they've been teaching us how it comes together.
Bringing biology and engineering together and examining how they can mutually inspire each other. So how can we understand more about biology through robotics? And then how can we engineer better or have robots perform better based on what we learn from animals?
I thought the class would be a good way to bridge the gap between engineering and biology as a biomedical engineer.
I found so far that the biology is a really good inspiration for a lot of the robotic systems. My group's robot is searching out these sources of colored light while it's also avoiding obstacles using sonar navigation.
We're using a visual and thermal sensor.
And then also using ultrasonic sensors on either side of the robot.
So we have to program the robot to be able to sense if it's an obstacle or if it's the object that we want.
To use different senses that animals have in the real world to detect objects, respond to those objects, and then a big thing is to be able to return home.
I'm Matthew Hook. I am a second year engineer for biomedical engineering.
Hi, my name is Zoe Hartman. I'm a third year neuroscience major with a focus in psychology.
I'm Nicole Addison. I'm a biology major with a concentration in animal sciences.
My name is Neil Lee and I go to Princeton High School.
My name is Jonathan Hendricks. I'm a freshman in mechanical engineering and I'm also pursuing an accelerated master's in robotics engineering.
I am currently a fifth year in biomedical engineering. Working with other individuals from different majors, it's been honestly a teaching moment for me from the engineering side of things with programming, but also a learning moment because then they can also teach me more about the biology base.
Starting from the classroom and out in the real world, people have different personal experiences, educational experiences.
All of those different experiences are gold mines that you can use on the team and use to build better solutions and better designs.
One person's not going to know everything and be good at everything, so having a more diverse group of people offers more opportunities for people to learn from each other, for peer learning, and for people to build off each other's strengths and weaknesses.
Having more than one professor is amazing and can make the class easier.
I think it's really interesting. You get multiple points of view on one subject. It sparks more interest in biology.
Seeing the biology professors reference things in the engineering field and the engineering professors reference things in the biology field so that those overlap, and you do get a better feel for where those things come together.
I think it's a really good way to do a class that's so diverse in topics like this one. Very good class, and I was expecting it to be very entertaining, but it honestly turned out even better than I was expecting it to.